Hey everyone, welcome to my third video on RFID and the Flipper Zero. In the last video, we looked at the T5577 programmable RFID tag and learned the format for the configuration block so we could set the modulation, data rate, and the number of user data blocks. In this video, we look at the user data block in detail for both the H10301, the popular EM4100, and the AWID protocol. Let's get started. The first protocol we're going to look at is the EM4100. On the flipper, we see the data is 1A016573D1. When I press enter, the spreadsheet fills in. The numbers we entered appear in column A. In the previous video, we calculated block 0 for the T5577. And this video is focused on determining the user blocks of T5577, which starts at block 1. All of the highlighted text in the spreadsheet is concatenated together to form the data that we send. The EM4100 always starts by sending a preamble of 9 ones. We converted each hex value into binary. For example, 5 is 0101. There's a table on the far right if you need help going between hex and binary. For each 4-bit value, we calculate an even parity. For even parity, we put a value so the total number of ones, including the parity bit, is even. In 0101, we had 2 ones, which is even, so we put 0 for our parity bit. In 0111, we had 3 ones, so our parity bit is 1, which makes the total 4 ones, which is even. Next, we have even parity for the 4 columns of data. For example, in our first column, we have 2 ones, so we have a 0 for our parity bit. In our last column, we had 7 ones, so we put 1 in our parity to make it even. The EM4100 ends with a 0 value as the stop bit. We combine the 9-bit preamble, the 54 bits of data and parity, and our stop bit for a total of 64 bits. The first 32 bits are block 1, and the second 32 bits are block 2. And then finally, we convert the data back into hexadecimal. In Rogue Master firmware, we'll open the 125 kHz app. We'll go down to Extra Actions. We'll go to Write T5577 block. No, it's not password protected. We'll type in our block 0 data. Hit save. Select page 0. Block 0. Choose no to set read-only prompt. Hold the tag against the flipper and press start. We repeat the same process for block 1. No, it's not protected. We type in our block 1 data. We select page 0, and this time we select block 1, no to read only, and start. And finally, we do the block 2 data, no, it's not protected. Type in the block 2 data. Select page 0, block 2. No for read only, and start. And then finally, we'll read our tag to confirm that it's emulating the device. There it is. That's our EM4100. Next, let's look at the H10301 protocol from HID. On the flipper, we see our data is 6573D1. When I press enter, the spreadsheet fills in. The numbers we entered appear in column A. The highlighted text in yellow and orange is concatenated to form the data we send. The H10301 starts by sending a preamble of 0001101. Next, it always sends a company code of 1. All of the highlighted orange data is Manchester encoded. In Manchester encoding, for every 1, we write 1 followed by a 0, and for every 0, we write 0 followed by a 1. Manchester encoding the company code, we send 6 0 1s followed by a 10. Next, the H10301 sends a format of 1. We Manchester encode the format, so we send 10 0 1s followed by a 10. Let's jump down to the hex values. We'll look at the Wigan data in a minute. Our hex values are converted to binary. For example, 6 becomes 0110. We then Manchester encode the data, so it becomes 01101001. Now let's discuss the Wigan even parity that we skipped over. The first three nibbles in binary has 7 ones. We're doing even parity, so we need to set the parity bit, so we have 8 ones. We then Manchester encode the bit, so we have 10. For Wigan odd parity, we use the last three nibbles. There are 6 ones, so we set the parity bit to make it odd. We then Manchester encode the bit, so we have 10. We combine all the highlighted binary data, and then we break it apart into block 1, block 2, and block 3. Finally, we convert from binary back to hexadecimal. Next, we'll write the 4 blocks of data to our T5577. Again, block 0 was from the previous video, so if you want to learn how to make that value, that 107060, watch the previous video. And then blocks 1 through 3 are the ones we calculated in this video. And now when we read the T5577 tag, it's a H10301 with our data. Next, let's look at the AWID protocol. On the flipper, we see our data is 1A, B2, B9, E8, C1, and then 8 zeros that I'm not going to type. When we press enter, the spreadsheet fills in. The numbers we entered appear in column A. We hard-coded the 8 zeros, but you could copy the formula from the rows above if you had a card that uses that data. All of the highlighted text in the spreadsheet is concatenated to form the data we send. AWID starts by sending a preamble of 7 zeros and a 1. Next, we decode all of the hex data into binary. For every 3 bits of binary data, we calculate an odd parity bit. So we'll start with 000 and have our odd parity bit be 1. And then we'll have 110, and then 101, and then 011. And we continue this process for the rest of our data, calculating our parity bits. We combine all the highlighted data, and then we break it into 32-bit chunks for block 1, block 2, and block 3. We ignore the last 8 bits, as the protocol doesn't use all the bits that are displayed. And just like before, we'll write our block 0 data, and then we'll write our block 1 data, and then our block 2 data, and finally our block 3 data. And then we'll read the tag. And there it is, AWID with all of our hex information. Thanks for your time today. Hopefully now you know how to calculate user data blocks for the T5577. You understand even and odd parity bits and Manchester encoding. Most of the other low-frequency RFID protocols use similar techniques to the ones in this video. Please like and subscribe. In a future video, we'll talk about how to create that hex data we used for a given facility and card number. Modifying the card number may give you access to additional areas, which can be helpful during a pen test. Just make sure it's in your written agreement. If you have any questions, please leave them below or on my Discord server.